कॉलेज, डायरेक्टर ऑफ द कॉलेज, फैकल्टी मेंबर्स, रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स ऑफ द कंपनीज एंड माय डियर यंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे इंडिया हैज एन अपॉर्चुनिटी पार्टिसिपेशन स्पेशली इन द जॉब मार्केट, वर्ल्ड वाइड जॉब मार्केट. The developing countries, developed countries, the demography is against them. They have aging population. India is the youngest country population wise. We have very young population who will be our working force in the world in times to come in next 15, 20, 30 years. The country has the opportunity now to have more share in the world economy. As on date, India has every sixth human being on this globe is Indian. We have a population of 15%, global population of 15 to 16% today. But only from the global GDP, is India. India has only 3% of the global assets against 15-16% population. This is very disproportionate. If we have to increase our ratio of GDP or assets, wealth of the world, that is only possible through good education. Our country has recognized this federal level in Delhi, and state governments are giving more importance to education sector in last one decade than it was earlier years. But still, the education standards are wanting. We have established large number of educational institutions, but the companies find that degrees given by most of the colleges are not up to their requirements. Our professional colleges need to increase the level of education, methodology and content wise. I would like to inform the representatives of the companies who have come for placement that they should give opportunities to the children in the two-tier, three-tier cities, towns, not only to the elite institutions of IITs and urban-based institutions. They will get good material, human material, from tier two and tier three town-located institutions. When it comes to leadership, whether it is political leadership or corporate leadership or in any other sector, we require the three Qs. And the gradation of three Qs is intelligence quotient, and how do we assess the child or the grown-ups? We are still measuring the personalities of young students by the first Q only, that is intelligence quotient. We only look at their marks, how much information they have gathered in their mindsets during their education. That is intelligence quotient. But that intelligence quotient is not enough. More than it is emotional quotient. The person has a knowledge, but he has no guts. Person has the knowledge, he has no capability of decision making. Person has the knowledge, but he is not able to compete. He is not able to face the stress level in the competition. The EQ is more important than the IQ. And I can tell the companies that you will get better EQ among the students coming from rural areas. Because of their hardships, because they are coming to this level with the limited available opportunities to them. They never had put opportunities of education back at villages, whereas urban areas do have. If the students from rural areas having schooling from the rural schools have come to these colleges, in long term they will do better. They are tough, they are mentally tough, they are physically tough, they have a better strength to bear the competition. Urban children may not like my this statement, but it is correct. I stand by it. Third view is passion quotient. If you have gone through the newspapers or the media reports, we have two top American citizens in the country for last 2-3 years. The last 2-3 days, we have the Bill Gates, almost the richest human being on this earth. He never went to any university. He's a college dropout. Another old man, Warren Buffett. He has also not gone to any Oxford or any best of the universities or IITs or IIMs like universities. He is also a homegrown person. He is again the among the first three richest persons of on this globe, not America, not any country. How they have achieved this level? Because they had the highest passion level. Third Q is passion level, PQ, passion quotient. When we study, when we work, if our passion level is high, that can always supplement or complement the IQ level. For having good leadership, we need to increase the emotional quotient as well as passion quotient of our children studying in the schools or in the colleges. In the country, 80% of the people lived in villages, and 80% of the GDP of national GDP globe was based on agriculture. But today, the population of rural India has come down from 80 to 70%. But the percentage of GDP, percent of the wealth of the nation, is not directly related to agriculture sector. All wealth is in service sector. That is coming up in the 15% of the wealth of the country. That is, this variety is coming. How agitations are coming up in the country, whether it is rural agitation, whether it is that agitation, and in other areas of the country also, such agitation will come up from the agricultural communities. Because the availability of opportunities that is going down in the village areas. Our corporate world, this time is continued. We are heading towards more tough situations in the country. Any country, when research study was carried out by A.S. Moore, in comparison to other countries, it was found that when parameters, or it was research on different parameters. Number one was whether history of a country. Egyptian civilization is almost of the same history. But America, nobody knows about America beyond 450 years. Nobody knows whether natural resources are criteria for richness. It is again no. Recently you have seen Japan. Japan, the smallest island, does not have even a single material, natural resources on its island. They have no natural resources, no minerals. But almost second economy in the world, smallest island, smallest country, but the second economy in the world just after states. India has, China has just reached equivalent to it, just by sheer hard work. then whether Indians or this brown race must again be known. If we see more than 40% of the NASA engineers, they are Indians. NASA uses the latest level of technology, research or invented or discovered in the world on this globe. More than 30-35% of the medical professors in the US and European universities, they are Indians. IT industry, Silicon Valley in America, IT industry in India, they have shown we have the best skills in the world. But then why India is still lagging behind? It was found out otherwise, the reverse. Why, what's the difference between developed societies and the poor societies? It was found all those countries, all those societies which have a better attitude, they develop and honor the rights of your neighbors. When you have a compassion for your neighbors, punctuality in life, regard for quality. These are the ingredients of attitude of every citizen of those societies and countries which makes them to go ahead in life. Academic achievements achieved so far are very less component to succeed in life. More ingredients of life are emotional quotient and passion quotient. The company should not only give importance and their urge to do something, their passion to do better things in life. They should make consideration to live also. And I hope the college is giving a good and bring the information available to best of the institutes in the country or in the world and to the remote institutions like this situated slightly far away from the